If you haven't subscribed already, ring that bell to get notified when new movies are posted. Chris Young here from HomeKit Geek. Today we're going to look at the Netatmo Welcome Camera. This is an indoor camera. It is 1.8 by 1.8 by 6 inches tall. It is micro USB powered, and what's kind of cool about this is it's both wired and wireless. It's 2.4 gigahertz BGN on the wireless side, but if you do have a wired infrastructure, you can plug this in as well, which is nice. You can get that the HD video off of your Wi-Fi, you know, free up some bandwidth there. It is micro USB powered, internal storage, which is important in that this camera does, it really requires the SD card in it. In fact, it won't even record if the SD card is not in it, right? So internal storage, that's where all the video is stored. You have cloud storage-ish, which is kind of a little bit interesting about this, I find at least. They store a picture of the most clear face from a video in the cloud. They don't store the video, so which is kind of cool. You have facial recognition, up to 32 faces, 130 degree field of vision. You got night vision in here. They have put some extra motion sensitivity around things like pet detection, those kinds of things. And most interesting to us in the HomeKit camp, it is supposed to be soon HomeKit compatible. So realize that as of the recording of this video on October 29th, 2018, it is not HomeKit compatible yet. Now, unlike some other vendors, I actually do believe they will get there. The app, we've seen indication that it's happening. We've seen people claiming to be on the beta. And the fact that they have the Netatmo Outdoor, their presence cam as well, which is basically the same firmware, and they were able to enable that for HomeKit, I have a feeling this is going to be coming and possibly coming soon. So, you know, do with that information what you will. Make your purchasing decision based on the fact that it doesn't have HomeKit, but it might someday. Don't get your hopes up. They could be pulling a ring here. Okay, let's take a look at the unboxing. So, full disclaimer, I actually put it back in the box to take it out. I've been running this for about a year. So, you know, I want to be honest with you guys. So you can see here the box, it's pretty clearly marked, revolutionary camera, not a bad price, not extremely expensive. I think I picked this up for, it was about $150 roughly at the time. They may have dropped since then. And it's got pretty much everything you need in it, right? It's clearly marked, the box is well put together. And as we open it up, you'll see, you know, you've got this Tom Lily. They suggest that it's facial recognition, so we know that's going to be in there, right? We get the box open, which happens fairly quickly, and you can see nicely packed in here is the camera. So again, I did put that back in, and you can see it's this cylindrical shape. It says Netatmo on it. You can see it's a camera. All of that is good. If I actually compare this, and I will just grab my Healthy Home Coach over here. So this is one of their air quality sensors. It's almost exactly the same size, you know, might be just a tiny, tiny bit shorter. The Netatmo Healthy Home Coach, on the other hand, is micro USB, but you can look at the back here, which is kind of cool. Got the RJ45, so Ethernet. You've got the micro USB for power, and of course, you've got the SD card, micro SD card, for recording the audio as well. If we look into it, they supply, very nice of them, a micro USB charge cable. They also supply a power adapter, and I will let you know that mine actually didn't survive. The power adapter eventually died on me, just stopped working completely. I'm not quite sure why that was, whether kids hit it or whatever. All these things happen, right? I'm actually quite amazed. I've got a couple of these cameras, and I've had my kids knock this over a bunch of times, and it just keeps working. I definitely would not try the fall test repeatedly as has happened in my house. Don't try that at your house. But these are very, very sturdy built cameras, and they have survived a lot. So if we go in, we're going to create our standard accounts here, and we will go through the setup process again. Would it like to allow notifications? Obviously we do. They have quite good notifications actually, including, I will add a little picture here of the Apple Watch integration, which actually sends a picture of it right onto your watch, which is nice, right? You don't even have to look at your phone. You can say, hey, what's going on there? So the setup is really relatively simple here. You just turn it upside down and wait until you see the blue light glowing. This operation may take a few minutes. Right, select an accessory. There we go. The Netatmo welcome. So I'm guessing here that's going to be done through a Bluetooth connection, which is kind of standard in these kinds of devices. Right? Do we want to share the Wi-Fi settings? Well, we can do that. Connect the Wi-Fi network. Right? You don't have to use Wi-Fi, as I said. RJ45 works as well. So just plug it into your switching infrastructure if you have that. Again, nice. You don't even have to put in your Wi-Fi settings. It just transfers over from whatever Wi-Fi network you're connected to. Now you choose a name for your camera, put it in the home where you want to install this. Again, this is not your Apple HomeKit home, your Amazon home, your Google home. This is going to be purely for the Netatmo security ecosystem here, right? It is what it is, at least at this point in time. If in the future they do the full integration into Apple HomeKit, there's going to be a little bit of a different potential setup here as they do that full HomeKit integration, right? So be aware of lighting. You don't necessarily want to push this towards a window, point it right at a window. You might not get the best experience at that point in time, right? So welcome and you. Okay, it hasn't seen anybody yet. So let's take a quick tour over to our settings and see what's available in there before we really get into kind of the meat of the camera, which is kind of the facial recognition, the image quality, all that kind of stuff, right? So you can see here, you've got the settings. You could set up a new tag, which is another product they have there at the top. You can kind of modify your settings if you want. You have your home, you set up a new camera. All of that is available in here. So if we click on home, we'll be able to dig in a little deeper here and start looking at some of the things like the time zone, you know, what rooms are in there. So I've got the family room in there right now. Advanced will give us some more advanced settings, obviously alert and recording settings, known people. When should I consider them away? So the device actually does some cool things as far as detecting who's home and when they're home, right? So that's kind of one of the other nice things about this is because it's got this intelligence around it, as it starts to integrate into other ecosystems like Google Home or Amazon's Madam A or HomeKit, we might actually be able to use that for presence detection, right? Smart notifications, switch on so the notifications, turn an unknown face, right? Those kinds of things. So, oh, that's kind of nice. I can tell you that I personally have seen it be quite useful when letting me know about, when kids' parties, things like that, where there are people's faces in there. I've also seen it go a little funny. So we'll get into that. So once you put the camera where you want it to be, you can start capturing people and faces, and then you can say, okay, well, what do I want to do with these things, right? So up to 32 faces can be caught and captured and starting to recognize them. So you can get, okay, so this one is me. You see that little question mark there? So that signifies that it was an unknown face. And you can see the question mark now goes away. Okay, so I can save my favorite videos. You know, gives me some good stuff in there. And as we go through, the camera is going to constantly be basically applying, you know, machine learning, artificial intelligence, whatever you want to call it. Their facial recognition engine is going to be using the photos, the videos that they see to constantly try to improve itself. And it's going to be asking you every once in a while, hey, is this a photo of X? Is it a photo of you, me, whatever, right? And in fact, as you get into each user's individual profile, you can always go in and look at the profile strength and say, okay, well, how good is the image recognition currently, or the facial recognition? Can it actually tell that I am me, or is it confusing me with, you know, maybe my son or dad or whatever that happens to be, right? So when you're creating your profiles, you can even do this from pictures. So you can see here, I actually took a picture of my son and created a new face for him. So this is Tristan. He's, you know, my oldest boy, wonderful young lad. And I can do that right from the picture, which is kind of cool. So you can kind of start aiming your system, arming your system, getting the facial recognition working without anybody else there. It's kind of nice. You know, I could potentially see using this in, you know, rental, Airbnb, those kinds of things. You could arm it to even allow the system to welcome your guests before they're even going to be there. So that's the tour. Now let's give you some of the other pieces of information you need. This device is really handy from a notification standpoint, but it can also be a little chatty. you can see here that, you know, when we come home, it's going to say, hey, Joshua's home, Micah's home, welcome home to me, right? So although those kind of happen, it can get a little chatty. I don't know what else to say other than that, right? So be aware of that. The other thing I would say is be patient. You know, looking here, you can see that a couple of these images, you know, in the bottom left, that's actually me. It already knows me, but the bottom left is me too. That's because the profiles haven't become strong enough yet. So you're going to have some misfires. You're going to see things over time, but it does get better over time. It just needs that information, that data. And every once in a while, you will get prompted with, hey, are these pictures, you know, so-and-so? And you do need to go in and let it know if they are indeed so-and-so or not, right? That's important. The system's going to get better as you do that. The other thing I want to point out is that camera placement is critical. If you have this pointed at your TV, you saw that it could identify someone from a picture. Well, you know, you can see Elliot from Mr. Robot there as well. So if you have it pointed at a TV, you might get a ton of notifications that, hey, unknown person is in your house, because it's actually picking that up off of your TV as characters scroll by on your TV. So be aware, camera placement, not just against the windows, is incredibly critical and important here. So the last thing I want to talk about quick is the HomeKit piece. This right here, this screen, is why I'm confident it's coming, but we've been waiting a while. It's been announced almost a year and a half, maybe 2 years. I think it's coming. It's going to get here, but be patient. Please buy this product on the merits of the product now, or wait until HomeKit comes out on it and is fully supported, if that is your purchasing requirement. Again, they were able to release the HomeKit support on the big brother of this, the outdoor version, the Presence Cam, which is, you know, that's good news. It's running the same software, so, you know, all of that is good news. But again, don't let this become like a Ring doorbell situation, where we've been waiting on 3 years, 2016, so almost 3 years for Ring to deliver, and there's still nothing in sight. I think we're better off with the Welcome Cam as far as HomeKit goes, and I expect to see it, you know, in the next couple of months. So what do you guys think? Is this something you'd consider putting in your house? It's definitely more expensive than a Wyze Cam, but I think that facial recognition piece, at least for me, really makes this a good purchase. I really like the added knowledge of not just knowing there's something going on in my house, but knowing that it is a person, who that person is. It's also nice as a parent, if you have kids coming home from school early and you're not there, or you're doing something else, you know, home office, whatever that happens to be, you know who is in your house and who's coming in. So you're not kind of wondering, you know, why are there footsteps upstairs? You're actually going to get a unknown person, or it's, you know, my teenager, those kinds of things. Questions, comments, put them below. Likes always appreciated. Share, please. The more people that I get eyes on this, the easier it is for me to continue making content for you guys, which is what I want to do. Subscribe if you haven't already. Please subscribe. That really does help. Ring that bell if you want to be notified. I'm still posting every Tuesday, every Thursday. HomeKit videos on Thursday, and something just smart home related on Tuesdays. So please ring the bell to be notified. And if you want to learn how to make your house just a little bit smarter using Apple HomeKit, do me a favor, check out the video links below in the details. There will be a coupon to my Udemy course. Thanks.